So we checked out of Venice, took a train first, and we got to Florence, where we took a bus over here. Oh man, my allergies have been so bad, and that's why my eyes, they just look terrible right now. I've been sneezing so much. This area is just so itchy.
Today, when we were at the bus station, there were pay bathrooms, and then I went to the grocery store to see if they just had a bathroom I could use, and at first they said no, and then they saw my belly, and then they said yes. Perks!
So we just got here to Siena. We'll be spending 2 days here in Siena, and then 2 days over at Florence after we're done here. And from both cities, we'll be checking out the countryside and doing wine tours. But first, let's go grab some lunch. Mm-hmm. Oh. We just came back from the pharmacy. My allergies are crazy right now.
My constipation is crazy. We need fiber, we need antihistamines.
The allergies are so bad, it's really hard to enjoy food, enjoy this place. Hopefully all the medicine that we bought will clear up everything.
Clear out everything.
So we're gonna head back to the hotel, take this medicine, then try to explore a bit more. I really like the square. Yeah, I was really looking forward to this square more than any other squares in Italy.
Oh.
Yeah, this was actually the thing I was most looking forward to. In the evening, coming here, having a drink. Yeah, something more peaceful about this square. I feel like people are more relaxed here. And now we're here at San Gimignano.
As someone that's doing the wine tour, do you feel disappointed that it's not that the whole day?
No, I'm glad this is mixed up with different activities. What do you think of the views here?
Very beautiful.
And now we're here at a saffron farm, and we're going to have lunch here. So we're here in Volterra with Priya, and we all got some gelato. And while I was walking, on our way to this piazza here, to just sit down, people watch, and finish our gelato, I almost got hit on by a bird, and it almost got right onto my ice cream. Got on my leg instead. We came home, freshened up a bit, and now heading over to the restaurant that I made reservations for.
That's good.
Kim, check out the shape of the pasta over here. These ones. What do they look like?
This is what happens when you let Daniel book a hotel. It's a troll's den. I already want to leave, but I can't because it's non-refundable. It's a non-refundable room. We got yelled at already for our passports when we arrived, and then we had to take an elevator that looked like it was gonna break.
It was on sale.
Not a good enough sale, it wasn't free. We can't even open our luggage, there's no space. And the toilet is the same place as the shower.
We haven't had lunch yet, so I picked out this spot. It's called Mr. Pizza. It's not all that spectacular or whatever. The prices are really cheap, but the view out here on the terrace is really nice. We're sitting right in front of the famous Duomo here in Florence.
Who it's supposed to be?
Yeah. Oh my gosh, that must be so hot.
He's from Harry Potter.
He's supposed to be Leonardo da Vinci. I was about to say Leonardo DiCaprio.
Dumbledore. Everywhere smells like poo.
There he is. That's the same guy.
Leonardo da Vinci.
It's
a nice bridge.
Some more snacks.
The chips are good, but they're not spicy.
passion fruit one later.
Yep. Oh, you got the best seat.
I know.
This was the summer house of this famous sculptor in Florence, Romano Romanelli.
Because Kim's pregnant and she's vegetarian, I ate all the delicious salami and also had a double portion of wine.
I had a bread and a cheese.
We just finished from our second wine tasting and I feel a bit tipsy because I drank not just my own wine but also Kim's wine. Just by the smell, Kim thought that this wine would be really good. So we got this bubbly white wine. I made sure not to rub it in too much to Kim how good the wine was. Kim.
So we were at a wine tour all day. And it was really enjoyable for Daniel. It was nice for me too, but it was really hard because I had to miss out on all the wines and the soft cheeses. I found that sometimes I felt a little grumpy, a little bit jealous, but I just tried to keep, you know, a really optimistic attitude and just remember that, you know, like this is for something good. This is for something better and it's temporary. And yeah, it was difficult, but it's worth it. So we're at a vegan restaurant to balance out, to compensate for the things that I missed out on today. And so we're at Il Vegano. And I read some reviews online. People say that the lasagna and the cheesecake are really good. So I think that we're gonna try those and some other things too.
Oh no!
Oh no!
No!
Round two, don't look in the camera, look in your glass. Yes. You really can't take me anywhere. I'm so embarrassing. You tried the lasagna. You said it's not bad.
I never said that.
Yes, you did.
Okay, yeah, I did. What's bad?